So a lot of students ask us how to do a good machine learning project. And this machine learning project could be for their undergraduate program, like during the BTech or BE, or their MTech or MS, even working professionals who want to do a real world project. They ask us how to do a good machine learning project. So here are the following steps that you could follow. First and foremost, you need to learn machine learning, which is super important, because if you don't know machine learning, you can't solve a real world machine learning problem. And for those of you who already know machine learning, that's great. For those of you who don't know machine learning, what you could do is we actually provide a link here for another video that we made, where we explain how to learn machine learning, what are the good resources to learn machine learning. Please follow that link, because it doesn't make sense to repeat all of that again here. Right. So once you have learned the basics of machine learning, the next important thing is to pick up a real world problem that interests you. By the way, machine learning is used in a lot of areas. It's used in healthcare. It's used in e-commerce. It's used by social networks like Facebook. It's even used in areas like agriculture, manufacturing, transportation. For example, it's used by Uber to decide how many cabs to place at a given location. It's also used in advertising. For example, Google shows you a lot of ads, right, online, and a lot of those ads are driven using machine learning and AI. So if you want more problems, there is always Kaggle.com. So Kaggle is an online repository of data sets. Also, it's a place where data scientists compete. So those of you who know programming competitions, Kaggle is a similar place where data scientists and machine learning engineers compete. So there are a lot of great data sets and great problems. For those of you who are interested in those problems, you could just go to Kaggle.com. Here is a small set of problems. For example, this is a problem on Kaggle. So again, the website is Kaggle.com. You can search for it. Here, you're trying to decide whether a patient has diabetes or not, right? Which is a very, very interesting, especially type 2 diabetes, which is a very interesting problem in healthcare, right? So there is another sample problem here where Mercedes-Benz is trying to see if they can do better testing of their equipment, right? Because Mercedes-Benz does a lot of testing of their equipment before it goes out, right? So here it's asking people to build speedier testing and lower carbon dioxide emission testing, right? Algorithms to let that happen. So this is an example in manufacturing. Similarly, in agriculture, here is a data set where, given some properties of soil, it would ask you to determine what type of soil it is. Right, there are five types of soil that you want to predict given a soil, given some properties of soil, right? And this is important in agriculture, because if you know the soil type, you know what types of grain can be grown there, right? So on Kaggle, you get lots of data sets. You get tremendous amount of data on Kaggle for lots of problems that might interest you, right? So there are lots of data sets. There are free data sets. There are competitions that you can participate in. So Kaggle is a great resource for anybody who's looking for new problems, wherein you can also get data, right? For example, if you cook up your own problem and if you don't have data, you can't do machine learning on it, right? So using Kaggle as a great source of data and also great problems is what I would recommend. And as I just mentioned, this ML project could be done by students who are in their final year of undergrad, like in BTech or BE, or in their final year of master's, or even as a course project. Even working professionals who want to do this during their weekends so that they learn machine learning. This is you could pick up your data sets from Kaggle and pick up a problem that interests you. It's always important. Like, for example, I personally like healthcare a lot. I also like e-commerce problems a lot because I worked in e-commerce for a long time, right? So given these problems, depending on what interests you, you can pick up a real world problem and apply machine learning to it. Right. So the process for doing machine learning is this. The very first step is something called exploratory data analysis. Here we are providing a link to a bunch of free videos on our website wherein we explain some of the techniques of doing simple exploratory data analysis. Right. And that could benefit you. So if you have time, please feel free to check out our free content on our website on how to do basic exploratory data analysis. Exploratory data analysis helps us know, given a data set, the basics about the data set. What is the data set about? How good is it? How bad is it? Etc. And typically in the industry, people either use Python or R for it. IPython is basically like an interactive Python framework, which is extensively used in the industry. This is used a lot in the industry because it's great, because it's a web-based interface where you could write code, show plots. And by the way, if you check out our free videos on exploratory data analysis, you see that all of it is done in IPython, right? The most important piece is, please document your work. Whatever project you're doing, please write a blog if you can and put your code on GitHub, right? So by writing a blog, it crystallizes your thought process. It also makes it easy for you to share your work with your friends or with your potential employers tomorrow. My recommendation is, if you're picking up a project, write a weekly blog based on all the experiments you've done, based on all the analysis you've done. Most importantly, please also document all the failed techniques. A lot of times what people do is, okay, whenever I tell them write a blog about your project, they write only the success stories. But think of it like writing a weekly diary of your experiments. Also write about failed methods and why they failed. It's important for you to understand why a technique did not work, because that helps you sharpen your understanding about techniques. And when you apply machine learning models, either classification models or regression models or clustering models, it's important to try the simplest models first, baseline models, very, very simple models first, and slowly, incrementally improve your algorithms to advanced and complex algorithms. Don't jump to an advanced algorithm straight. Always try the simple algorithms like logistic regression. First try the simple ones before you go into deep learning, right? So don't go to deep learning right away. First try and solve the simple problem using simple techniques. Sometimes simple techniques work much better than more complex techniques, right? So always apply simple baseline techniques like k-nearest neighbor, naive Bayes, logistic regression, simple algorithms before you go on to try advanced and more complex algorithms. Right? And try multiple of them. Don't just stick to your one favorite algorithm. Many people have one favorite algorithm like SVM or something, and they apply the same algorithm everywhere or the same model everywhere. Don't do that. Apply like 5 or 10 techniques that you're most comfortable with, so that you understand how to use multiple techniques, how to understand the results of multiple techniques, and when a technique works and when a technique fails. And please document all of your analysis, all of your experiments. It's very, very important to document them. Now, another thing is, if you could write a blog or a GitHub or put all your code in a GitHub, you'll be able to build a portfolio of your work, just like artists have portfolios, like photographers have portfolios, models have portfolios. You could build a data science portfolio of yourself by writing a blog, and you could put that portfolio or the profile of yours in your resumes whenever you're looking for a new job, right? Or even when you're interviewing as a fresher. And the most important thing is, if you have time, if you have the right mentorship, what you could do is, you could extend, for example, let's assume you tried a very simple algorithm like SVM. What you could do here is, because you learned why SVM is working and where SVM is not working for your given problem, you could do extensions. You could extend SVM. You could extend SVM. Do fundamental research. So if you're working in a top tier university, or if you have right mentors, if you have a right mentor, you could extend existing techniques to this current problem, thereby doing some fundamental research. You will be able to do fundamental research and probably publish. So those of you who are looking to get into a PhD program, right, probably should certainly do this, wherein you solve the real world problem using techniques that you already know, and see where these techniques are not working and make modifications to these techniques. Do fundamental research, right? Of course, for that you would require a good professor or a good mentor to help you, but especially those students who are looking for a PhD in machine learning should certainly attempt to do some extensions and fundamental research. Right. So these steps that I've just listed here, which is start with a real world problem, get real world data sets, do a lot of exploratory data analysis, and document your work. Please write a blog, and please also document methods that fail or techniques or analysis that has failed, that has not worked as well as you expect. And if you're looking for a PhD program in machine learning, it's always good to do extensions of existing techniques and do some fundamental research. Right. Most important of all, please build a portfolio for yourself by showcasing your work on a blog or GitHub. And this is useful whether you want to join a company or you want to join a company as a machine learning engineer or as a data scientist or even for a PhD program. It's always good to showcase your work to others, and writing a blog is a great way to do it.